Welcome to Chronicles of Time Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. Journey into the Amazonian Jungle. Chapter 1. The Mysterious Amazon. In the heart of the Amazon, where the trees stretch up to kiss the sky and the air hums with the secrets of ages, Ben Hudson, a seasoned explorer with eyes like the ocean and a spirit as untamed as the jungle itself, embarked on a journey that would etch his name in the annals of adventure. Ben had traveled far and wide, from the scorching sands of Egypt to the icy peaks of the Himalayas, but the Amazon was different. It was a living, breathing entity, a tapestry of green that whispered of ancient mysteries and untold stories. It was a feeling Ben couldn't get rid of as he trudged through the dense underbrush, his boots sinking slightly into the wet ground. The noises of the jungle came to life, including the soft rustle of leaves in the light wind, the distant voices of birds, and the occasional snap of a twig underfoot. But there was something more, a faint implication that he wasn't alone, beneath these well-known noises. Ben paused, wiping the sweat from his brow with the back of his hand. The heat was oppressive, a thick, heavy blanket that seemed to press down on him from all sides. He took a swig from his canteen, the water lukewarm but refreshing, and surveyed his surroundings. Towering trees with broad leaves formed a canopy overhead, filtering the sunlight into a kaleidoscope of greens and golds. Vines hung like serpents from the branches, and the air was thick with the scent of earth and growing things. He had heard rumors of an ancient temple hidden deep within the jungle, a place of power and mystery that had remained untouched by time. The locals spoke of it in hushed tones, their eyes wide with a mixture of fear and reverence. They said it was guarded by a mythical creature, a panther with fur as black as the night and eyes that glowed like emeralds. Ben, with his insatiable thirst for the unknown, knew he had to find it. The map he carried with him was old and worn, the edges frayed and the ink faded. It had been a lucky find, tucked away in a forgotten corner of a market in Rio de Janeiro. The seller, an old man with a weathered face and a knowing smile, had assured him it was genuine. Ben wasn't sure if he believed in the authenticity of the map, but something about it had called to him, a siren song he couldn't resist. As the day wore on, the jungle seemed to close in around him. The path, barely discernible under the tangle of vegetation, wound its way through the dense forest. Ben's machete swung in a steady rhythm, cutting a path through the undergrowth. He moved with purpose, every step taking him closer to his goal. Ben saw the temple for the first time as the sun was about to set, throwing deep shadows across the jungle floor. With its old stones coated in moss and spreading vines, it was nearly obscured by the surrounding vegetation. Grand and intimidating, it towered before him as a reminder of a vanished civilization. For a moment, Ben just stood there, taking it all in. The temple was magnificent, its walls etched with intricate carvings and symbols that spoke of a rich and complex history. The entrance was a gaping maw, a dark void that beckoned him forward. As he approached, the air grew cooler, the oppressive heat of the jungle receding as if in reverence to the sanctity of the temple. Ben's footsteps echoed on the stone floor, a lonely sound in the vast silence that enveloped him. He flicked on his flashlight, the beam cutting through the darkness, revealing the interior of the temple. The walls were lined with statues, their faces serene and enigmatic. The floor was a mosaic of tiles, each one a piece of a larger puzzle that Ben couldn't quite decipher. The sense of being watched returned, stronger than before. Ben could feel eyes on him, tracking his every move. He turned slowly, half expecting to see someone, or something, lurking in the shadows. But there was nothing, just the empty corridor stretching out behind him. He pressed on, deeper into the heart of the temple. The air grew heavier, laden with the scent of damp stone and ancient secrets. The beam of his flashlight danced over the walls, illuminating scenes of life and death, of gods and mortals, each one telling a story that had been lost to time. Ben's heart raced with excitement and a hint of fear. He was on the brink of something extraordinary, a discovery that could change everything. The temple held its secrets close, but Ben was determined to uncover them, to reveal the mysteries hidden within its ancient walls. As he rounded a corner, he came to a sudden stop. There, in the beam of his flashlight, was the panther. It was exactly as the legends had described, a creature of shadow and light, its fur a glossy black that seemed to absorb the light. Its eyes glowed with an inner fire, a bright, piercing green that fixed Ben with an unwavering gaze. Ben's breath caught in his throat. He had expected to find something in the temple, but nothing as tangible and awe-inspiring as this. The panther was more than just a guardian of the temple, it was a part of it, a living embodiment of its power and mystery. For a long moment, Ben and the panther stared at each other, each assessing the other. Ben could feel the weight of its gaze, a tangible pressure that seemed to probe the depths of his soul. Then, slowly, the panther turned and disappeared into the shadows, its presence lingering like a whisper in the air. Ben was left standing alone in the silent temple, his heart pounding in his chest. He knew then that his journey was only just beginning. The temple was a labyrinth of secrets, and the panther was the key to unlocking them. Ben was ready for whatever lay ahead, his spirit alight with the thrill of the unknown. As he delved deeper into the heart of the temple, each step taking him further into the unknown, Ben knew that this was more than just an adventure. It was a journey into the very heart of the jungle, a quest for knowledge and discovery that would test his limits and reveal the true nature of the world around him. The temple awaited, its ancient secrets guarded by the mythical panther, and Ben was determined to uncover them, no matter what the cost. The journey into the heart of the jungle had only just begun. Chapter 2: The Panther's Watch. As Ben Hudson ventured deeper into the labyrinth and corridors of the ancient temple, the air around him seemed to pulse with an ancient rhythm, like the heartbeat of the jungle itself. The walls were adorned with elaborate carvings depicting scenes of a forgotten civilization, warriors in battle, priests in prayer, and animals in harmony with nature. Among these, the panther was a recurring motif, its image a symbol of power and grace. The temple's architecture was a marvel, a blend of art and engineering far ahead of its time. The stones were perfectly cut and fitted together without mortar, their surfaces smooth to the touch. As Ben ran his fingers over them, he could feel the faint vibrations of the temple, as if it were alive. His progress was slow, hindered not only by the physical obstacles, but also by a growing sense of unease. The deeper he went, the stronger the sensation became, a feeling of being watched by unseen eyes. It was an eerie, unsettling feeling that crawled under his skin, but Ben pushed on, driven by his insatiable curiosity. He came upon a vast chamber, its ceiling lost in shadows. The air was cooler here, and the only sound was the soft echo of his footsteps. In the center of the room stood a statue of the mythical panther, its size larger than life. The statue was carved from a single block of black stone, so dark it seemed to absorb the light around it. Its eyes, made of some luminescent material, shone with a ghostly light, casting an ethereal glow over the chamber. Ben approached the statue cautiously, aware of the way of history that surrounded him. The craftsmanship was exquisite, the details so lifelike that for a moment he thought he saw the statue's chest rise and fall, as if breathing. He reached out to touch it, half expecting the stone to be warm under his fingers. Suddenly, the chamber was filled with a low growl, resonating through the stone floor and up into Ben's bones. He froze, his hand inches from the statue. The growl seemed to come from everywhere and nowhere, a sound as ancient as the jungle itself. Then, from the shadows, emerged the panther, not a statue, but a living, breathing creature. Its coat was a glossy black, each muscle rippling under its skin as it moved with a predator's grace. Its eyes fixed on Ben, unblinking and intense. Ben's heart hammered in his chest. He had faced danger before, but nothing like this. The panther was the embodiment of the wild, a creature of beauty and terror. He stood still, knowing that any sudden movement could provoke an attack. The panther circled him, each step deliberate and measured. Ben could see now that it was not just a panther, there was something otherworldly about it, a sense of intelligence and awareness far beyond that of a normal animal. After what seemed like an eternity, the panther stopped and sat back on its haunches, still watching him. Ben took a careful breath and slowly, very slowly, backed away from the statue. He kept his eyes on the panther, trying to read its intentions. The panther's gaze never wavered, its eyes a deep, mesmerizing green. Then, with a graceful leap, it disappeared into the shadows, as silently as it had appeared. Ben let out a breath he hadn't realized he'd been holding. His mind was racing, trying to make sense of what he'd just experienced. The panther was more than just a guardian of the temple, it was a part of its very essence, a link to its ancient past. He turned his attention back to the statue. There was something about it, something he couldn't quite put his finger on. He examined it closely, looking for any markings or clues that might reveal its secrets. As he studied the statue, he noticed something unusual about the base. There were grooves in the stone, almost imperceptible, forming a pattern that seemed familiar. He traced the pattern with his finger, and a sudden realization hit him. It was a map, a map of the temple itself. Ben's excitement grew as he followed the map, his mind piecing together the puzzle. The temple was more than just a series of chambers and corridors. It was a maze designed to protect something of great value. With a new sense of purpose, Ben set out to explore the temple, following the map etched in the base of the Panther statue. The corridors twisted and turned, leading him deeper into the heart of the temple. The air grew heavier with each step, laden with the scent of earth and stone. He encountered more statues along the way, each one a masterpiece of ancient art. But it was the frescoes on the walls that caught his attention. They told a story, a narrative of a people and their relationship with the natural world. The panther was a central figure in these stories, a guardian spirit that protected the temple and its secrets. Ben felt a deep connection to these ancient people, a sense of kinship that transcended time. He was no longer just an explorer, he was a pilgrim, a seeker of truth in a world shrouded in mystery. The map led him to a small chamber, hidden away from the main path. The room was circular, with a domed ceiling that echoed with the slightest sound. In the center of the room was a pedestal, and on it, a single object, a key, made of a material that shimmered in the dim light. Ben approached the pedestal, his heart racing with anticipation. The key was beautifully crafted, its surface etched with symbols that matched those on the walls of the temple. He knew instinctively that this key was the answer, the means to unlock the temple's greatest secret. He picked up the key, its weight reassuring in his hand. As he did, the chamber began to tremble, a low rumble that grew in intensity. Dust fell from the ceiling, and the walls seemed to shift, rearranging themselves into a new configuration. Ben realized that the temple was alive, responding to his actions. He had triggered something, a mechanism that had lain dormant for centuries. The chamber was no longer a dead end, it was a gateway, leading to the heart of the temple. With the key in his possession, Ben set out once again, following the shifting corridors of the temple. The air was electric with energy, the very stones of the temple alive with anticipation. The panther appeared again, its presence both a warning and a guide. It led him through the maze, its eyes glowing in the darkness. Ben followed, trusting in the wisdom of this ancient guardian. Finally, they came to a gray hall, its ceiling so high it was lost in shadows. In the center of the hall was a door, massive and imposing, its surface covered in carvings that told the story of the temple and its people. Ben stepped forward, the key in his hand. He knew that beyond this door lay the answer to all his questions, the culmination of his journey into the heart of the jungle. He inserted the key into the lock and with a deep breath, turned it. The door creaked open, revealing a chamber beyond that glowed with an otherworldly light. Ben stepped through the doorway, the panther at his side. He was no longer just an explorer. He was a part of the temple's story, a link in the chain that connected the past to the present. As he entered the chamber, the secrets of the temple were revealed to him, a gift from the ancient guardians who had watched over this place for centuries. The journey into the heart of the jungle had brought him to this moment, a moment of discovery and understanding that would change his life forever. The panther watched him, its eyes shining with pride and satisfaction. It had guided him to this place, and now its task was complete. With a final nod of acknowledgement, it disappeared into the shadows, leaving Ben to face the truth of the temple alone. Ben stood in the chamber, surrounded by the echoes of a long-forgotten past. He had found what he was looking for, the heart of the jungle and the soul of the temple. The journey had been long and fraught with danger, but it had been worth it. He had uncovered the secrets of the ancient temple, and in doing so, had discovered something even more valuable, a deeper understanding of himself and his place in the world. The temple had revealed its mysteries to him, and now it was time for him to return to the world outside, to share the knowledge he had gained with those who would listen. The journey into the heart of the jungle was over, but the adventure was just beginning. Chapter 3. The Temple of Riddles. As Ben Hudson delved deeper into the heart of the ancient temple, he found himself in a world far removed from the lush greenery of the Amazon jungle. The air was cooler here, the walls echoing the soft, persistent drips of water from the unseen crevices in the ceiling. Each step Ben took reverberated through the vast, empty halls, a lone testament to his presence in this forgotten world. The corridors of the temple were a labyrinth, twisting and turning in a seemingly endless maze. The walls were adorned with intricate carvings, each telling a story of the people who had built this place. Warriors in battle, priests in prayer, animals both real and mythical, each carving was a piece of a larger puzzle, waiting to be solved. Ben's eyes were drawn to the depictions of a panther, its form repeated throughout the temple's design. It was a creature of grace and power, and he felt a strange connection to it, as if it were guiding him through the temple. As he ventured further, Ben came upon a series of chambers, each presenting its own challenge. The first was a room filled with statues, their eyes seeming to follow him as he moved. There was an eerie sense of being watched, and Ben couldn't shake off the feeling that the statues were more than just stone. He approached the first statue cautiously, studying its form. It was a figure of a warrior, its hand extended as if offering something. Ben noticed a small, round depression in the statue's palm, just the right size for the key he had found earlier. Ben breathed out deeply and set the key in the statue's hand. A brief interval of quietness was followed by the sound of stone grating on stone, filling the space. The statue started to move, revealing a secret opening in the wall with its arm descending. Ben's heart raced with excitement. This was it, the first clue to unlocking the temple's secrets. He stepped through the passage, his flashlight cutting through the darkness. The next chamber was even more challenging. It was a vast room, its floor a mosaic of tiles and a dizzying array of colors. Ben realized that it was a puzzle, a giant jigsaw that needed to be solved to open the door on the other side of the room. He set to work, carefully studying the pattern of the tiles. It was a complex design, but Ben was determined to solve it. He moved the tiles around, trying different combinations until finally, with a click, the last piece fell into place. The door opened, revealing yet another chamber. This one was different from the others, its walls lined with shelves filled with ancient scrolls and books. Ben's eyes widened in wonder. This was a treasure trove of knowledge, the collective wisdom of a civilization long gone. He picked up a scroll, unrolling it carefully. The language was unfamiliar, but the drawings were clear. They were instructions, a guide to the next part of the temple. then followed the drawings, each one leading him deeper into the heart of the temple. He encountered more puzzles, each more complex than the last. There were rooms with walls that moved, floors that shifted under his feet, and ceilings that seemed to close in on him. But Ben was undeterred. He was like a character in magical adventure, braving the dangers and solving the mysteries of the temple. Each challenge he overcame brought him closer to the ultimate truth, the secret that the temple guarded. As he progressed, Ben began to notice a pattern. The puzzles were not just random challenges, they were a test, a way to prove his worthiness to receive the temple's secrets. He realized that he was being judged, not just by the temple, but by the Panther itself. The final chamber was the most daunting of all. It was a vast, circular room, its ceiling a dome of shimmering crystals that cast a kaleidoscope of colors on the walls. In the center of the room was a pedestal, and on it, a single object, a crystal skull, its surface glowing with an inner light. Ben approached the pedestal, his heart pounding in his chest. He knew that this was the key to the temple's greatest secret. He reached out to touch the skull, and as he did, the room began to tremble. The crystals in the ceiling shone brighter, their light converging on the skull. Ben could feel the power of the temple flowing through him, a surge of energy that was both exhilarating and terrifying. And then, the skull began to speak. Its voice was a whisper, a gentle murmur that filled the room. It told Ben the story of the temple, of the people who had built it and the panther that guarded it. It spoke of a time when humans and nature lived in harmony, a time of peace and prosperity. Ben listened, spellbound by the tale. He realized that the temple was more than just a structure of stone and mortar. It was a symbol of a lost way of life, a reminder of what could be achieved when people lived in balance with the world around them. As the skull finished its story, the room fell silent. The crystals dimmed, their light fading until only the glow of the skull remained. Ben stood there, alone in the darkness, his mind reeling from what he had heard. He knew that he had been given a gift, a piece of knowledge that was meant to be shared with the world. The temple had revealed its secrets to him, and now it was his responsibility to use that knowledge for the greater good. Chapter 4. The Ancient Secret Unveiled. After navigating the labyrinth of the ancient temple, with its myriad of enigmatic puzzles and silent sentinels, Ben Hudson stood on the threshold of the final revelation. The air in the innermost chamber was still, heavy with the weight of untold centuries. His torchlight flickered across the walls, casting elongated shadows that danced eerily in the confined space. The chamber was circular, the walls inscribed with intricate glyphs and symbols whose meanings were lost to time. At the center, a pedestal carved from obsidian stood solemnly, cradling an object that shimmered with a strange, ethereal light. It was a crystal, multifaceted and luminous, pulsating with a life force that seemed almost sentient. Ben approached the pedestal with a mix of trepidation and awe. His journey had been fraught with dangers and challenges, each step leading him deeper into the heart of the unknown. He reflected on the trials he had faced, the chamber of shifting floors, the corridor of whispering statues, the room where the very air seemed to solidify around him. Each test had pushed him to his limits, both physically and mentally, but he had persevered. Now, standing before the crystal, Ben felt the culmination of his quest within his grasp. He reached out, his fingers trembling slightly as they made contact with the cool surface of the crystal. A surge of energy coursed through him, a torrent of images and emotions that flooded his senses. Visions swirled before his eyes, scenes of the temple in its prime, a hub of knowledge and wisdom, a sanctuary where the boundaries between the physical and the spiritual were blurred. He saw the people who had built this place, their faces etched with the lines of knowledge and understanding. They were scholars, artists, and philosophers, united in their quest for enlightenment. The visions shifted, revealing the purpose of the temple. It was a repository of knowledge, a library of the collective wisdom of a civilization that had understood the delicate balance of nature and the cosmos. The crystal was the key, a conduit for the accumulated knowledge of generations. Ben saw the downfall of this great civilization, not through war or conquest, but through a gradual forgetting. The harmony that had once existed between humanity and the natural world had frayed, leading to a slow but inevitable decline. The temple, once a beacon of hope and understanding, had been reclaimed by the jungle, its secrets sealed away until the time was right for them to be rediscovered. As the visions faded, Ben was left with a profound sense of responsibility. The knowledge contained within the crystal was not just historical, it was a blueprint for a better future. He understood now that his journey had been more than a quest for adventure, it had been a pilgrimage, a journey towards a greater understanding of the past and a vision for the future. Standing alone in the heart of the ancient temple, Ben felt a deep connection to the people who had built this magnificent structure. They had understood something that modern civilization had forgotten, the importance of living in harmony with the natural world, of respecting the delicate balance of life. The crystal in his hand was more than just an artifact, it was a symbol of hope. It contained the wisdom of a lost civilization, a guide to a way of living that could restore the balance between humanity and nature. Ben knew that he couldn't keep this discovery to himself. The world needed to know about the temple and its secrets. He had to share the knowledge contained within the crystal to spread the message of harmony and balance. As he made his way out of the temple, Ben felt a sense of urgency. He had to act quickly to share what he had learned before it was too late. The world was on the brink of ecological disaster, and the knowledge contained within the temple could be the key to averting catastrophe. He emerged from the temple into the bright light of day, blinking against the harsh sunlight. The jungle around him was alive with the sounds of birds and insects, a symphony of life that was both beautiful and fragile. Ben made his way back to civilization, the crystal securely tucked away in his backpack. He knew that the journey ahead would be challenging, that there would be skeptics and naysayers who would doubt the authenticity of his discovery. But he was undeterred. He had a mission now, a purpose that went beyond mere adventure. He was a guardian of the knowledge contained within the temple, a messenger tasked with sharing a vision of a better future. As he trekked through the jungle, Ben thought about the panther that had guided him through the temple. It had been more than just a guardian, it had been a symbol of the connection between humanity and the natural world. He hoped that one day, humanity would understand and respect that connection, that they would learn to live in harmony with the world around them. Ben's journey had started as a quest for adventure, but it had become something much more. He had discovered an ancient secret, a message from the past that held the key to the future. And now, it was up to him to share that message with the world. The journey into the heart of the jungle had been a transformative experience for Ben. He had faced his fears, overcome challenges, and emerged with a newfound sense of purpose. He was no longer just an explorer, he was a messenger, a bearer of a message that could change the world. As he left the jungle behind, Ben looked back at the ancient temple, now hidden once again by the dense foliage. He knew that the temple would continue to guard its secrets, waiting for the next seeker who was brave enough to venture into its depths. But for now, it was up to Ben to share the knowledge he had gained, to spread the message of harmony and balance. The journey into the heart of the jungle was over, but the adventure of a lifetime was just beginning.